हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू गुरुकुल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज मनोज ढुल, इंग्लिश टीचर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फर्स्ट पोइम ऑफ द बुक मैरीगोल्ड। पोइम इज आइसक्रीम मैन। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द पोइम, लेट अस टॉक अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट द पोइट रचल फील्ड। सो दिस पोइम इज रिटन बाय रचल फील्ड। Rachel Field is an American novelist, poet, and fiction writer. She was born in 1894 and died in 1942. She is best known for her Newbery Award-winning novel, Hitty, Her First 100 Years. She also won the National Book Award in 1935. So this is all about the poet. Now let us discuss the poem, Ice Cream Man. Ice Cream Man is a very interesting and beautiful poem. So now, let us see what this poem is all about and what you are going to learn from this poem. Okay, children, you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of summer. Okay, tell me. Okay, I'll give a clue. What is cold, sweet, creamy, and wonderful to eat? It's everyone's favorite treat, especially on a hot summer day. So you tell me, what is it? Yes, it is an ice cream. So everyone's favorite person just might be an ice cream man who sells ice cream in summer season. So now let us read the poem. When summer's in the city and brings a blaze of heat, the ice cream man with his little cart goes trundling down the street. Beneath his round umbrella, oh, what a joyful sight! To see him fill the cones with mounds of cooling brown and white. Vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, or chilly things to drink. From bottles full of frosty fizz, green, orange, white or pink. His cart might be a flower bed of roses and sweet peas. The way the children cluster round as thick as honeybees. So once again, let's read the poem. When summer's in the city and brings a blaze of heat, the ice cream man with his little cart goes trundling down the street. Beneath his round umbrella, oh, what a joyful sight! To see him fill the cones with mounds of cooling brown and white. Vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, or chilly things to drink. From bottle full of frosty fizz, green, orange, white, or pink. His cart might be a flower bed of roses and sweet peas. The way the children cluster around as thick as honeybees. So let me explain and this entire poem to you. I know some words might be difficult, so let me make them easy for you. A bricks, a hardened block of mud or clay, which is used for buildings. Second, blaze. Bright flame or fire. Blaze, bright flame or fire. A next word, trundling. A trundling, moving on small broad wheels. Moving on small broad wheels. After that, beneath, under. Sight. Yes, this is sight, seen. After that, cones, cones with tapering end in the shape, which are used for ice cream. So, after that, cluster means gather around or group of similar things. Thick, densely or crowded. So these are the new words, these are the difficult words. Now let me explain. When summer's in the city and bricks a blaze of heat. So the poet says that whenever there is summer, when the summer is so hot, so scorching, then the ice cream man, the ice cream uncle comes to our street. So he pedals his car, he comes with his little cart, he pedals his cart like a cycle. He has a bell or a horn which he pump to let know the student he is down to the street. Beneath his round umbrella, oh what a joyful sight to see him fill the cones with mounds of cooling brown and white. So normally the ice cream man has an umbrella on his cart over his head. So under his umbrella the scene is so joyful, so beautiful. What is there under the umbrella? So to see him fill the cones with mounds of cooling brown and white. So under his umbrella there are so many cones which are filled with different color of ice creams and different colors of different flavors of ice cream. And right after that, vanilla, chocolate, strawberry or chilling things to drink from bottle full of frosty fizz, green, orange, white or pink. So the ice cream man has in his cart different flavors of ice cream like vanilla, chocolate, strawberry. He has also different cold drinks of different colors like green, orange, white or pink. In the last stanza, the poet compares the cart of the ice cream man with a flower bed. So his cart might be a flower bed of roses and sweet and peas, the way the children cluster round as thick as honeybees. So in the last stanza, the poet compares the cart of the ice cream man with a flower bed. And the poet, when the children gather around the cart of the ice cream man, so he compares the children with honeybees. So now let us discuss the technical aspect of the poem. In technical aspect of the poem, we will discuss three things: rhyming scheme of the poem, stanza of the poem and figure of speech. So rhyming scheme of the poem, as you see in the first stanza, when summer's in the city and bricks a blaze of heat, the ice cream man with his little cart goes trundling down the street. So each verse in this poem goes by the pattern of A, B, C, B. So this is the rhyming scheme of the poem, A, B, C, B. Let us see. So suppose this is A, this is B. Why this is B? Because these words, both the heat and city, these are not rhyming words. Now after that, city, heat, cart. So cart is also not the rhyming word. So C, street and heat, both are the rhyming word. Street, heat, a T sound is there at the end of the both words. So this is B. So the rhyming scheme of the poem is A, B, C, B. Now look at the last stanza. Bed, peach, round. Bed, peas and round and siege. So honeybees and peas, both are the rhyming words. So pattern is A, B, C and B. So this is the rhyming scheme of the poem, A, B, C, B. Now stanza, as you see, each stanza contains four lines, and a four line stanza is called quatrain. So this poem is in quatrain stanza. Right after that, figure of speech. In the last stanza, the poet compares the cart of the ice cream man with flower bed. When we compare two dissimilar things without as or like, that is metaphor. So here in this line, his cart might be a flower bed. So in this line, the poet uses a metaphor. The way the children cluster around as thick as honeybees. So in the last two lines, the poet compares the children with honeybees, but the poet used here as. If we compare two dissimilar things with the help of like or as, then this is a simile. So the poet used in this poem two figure of speech, metaphor and simile. Metaphor in this line, his cart might be a flower bed, and simile in the last two lines, the way the children cluster around as thick as honeybees. So in the last line, a simile is there. So this is all about the poem Ice Cream Man. So I hope you will enjoy it. So thank you very much and wish you all the best.